can't tell you.
Jean and Steve Green are worried about one of their donkeys.
What are you doing? Putting your snout up her? They mean more to us than you can imagine. I got them through Julian off somebody that was getting rid, and I got them for a 40th anniversary, and I've had them 3 years now.
We've got you a surprise. Now, I reckon these will make a nice addition to your farm.
Oh, beautiful!
This one's called Mabel, and this one's called Sybil.
Mabel has developed a mysterious problem.
Mabel, what's wrong with you, lass? Come on, speak to Dr. Green.
She keeps getting thinner and thinner.
She's losing grund. I think there's something sinister.
Well, she has lost a lot of condition, hasn't she?
Yeah. Pretty rapid, within 3 weeks, and she's gone rough at court. She looks like an odd grizzly bear. She's not happy-go-lucky, no.
Ah, she's, her ears are back a bit, aren't they?
Dr. Wright's coming to see you today, he is. He'll probably pinpoint what's wrong.
Mr. and Mrs. Green.
How are you?
I knew you wouldn't be far away, how are you?
Oh, sweet Kipper.
Don't you like it? I like Steve's. That's a real Bobby Dazzler. But Mabel's not so good, I understand.
No, Mabel's not so good.
No, do you want her out or not?
I think out maybe, because we can have a proper look at her outside, can't we?
Aye.
Sybil's out as well, but never mind. She can keep an eye on things. But she has lost weight, hasn't she, since I saw her last? Because she was a little bit on the plump side at one stage,
aye,
wasn't she?
She was. Been wormed?
Yes. Just be kind to Uncle Peter, while let's have a look. I'm just checking her teeth now, because one of the reasons why donkeys and horses and ponies can lose weight is if they're not chewing the food properly. And if they're not chewing the food properly, it could be because they've got dental pain. Those are not bad. Right, let's have a listen to her.
What we're listening for, Pete? Heart murmurs?
I'm just looking, yeah, listen for heart murmurs, Jean. Listen to see if her heart's regular, which it is. And I've got to say, her heart's very strong. Her stomach activity is good, Jean. There's lots of nice gurgling and rumblings in there, which is what we want.
Ah, just frozen.
You aren't gurgling and rumbling, are you?
No, because I've just had eggs, bacon and black pudding.
How do you keep your svelte-like figure? I'll never know. Right, now then. I think I'm gonna pinch a drop of blood from her, Jane.
Excuse me, young man. And you ain't having a drop of blood out of me, never. There's got no ruddy chance.
Well, I'll tell you what. I don't know anybody in Thurston that'd be able to hold you down while I'm
I'll bite like a bloody crocodile.
There we go.
And you know, she never twitched a whisker, did you?
Can we let him go?
Yeah.
There you go, baby.
That's it.
And we go.
Go on.
Thank you, Mr. and Mrs. Green, and I'll get these bloods off, and as soon as I've got some results, I'll give you a ring.
I feel a bit brighter about it, but I'm so concerned it could be the big C. I'll not know till blood tests come back.
Physically, I can't find anything to account for the weight loss. It may be an ageing change, but I just want to rule out anything else going on. So, this will be quite interesting.
Over at Jean and Steve's.
Morning, Mab. Morning, Sib. Have you been good?
The mystery of Mabel's illness is ongoing.
Mabel's not so clever. She's not so bad, but not so great. So, all hands on deck.
Peter's on his way back to see them, and he has some news.
We've got Mabel's blood sample results back, and there's a couple of things on there that's maybe a cause for concern. Is Mabel in a good mood today?
I couldn't tell this one. That's what? Up to do to find out.
You're all right. There's a good girl. Good girl, Mabel. That's it. There we are. Right, now, the changes we had on the blood are very, very slight, but it may just be an old age change. That's all. It might be nothing more. But it may be, there's a possibility that we have a thing called Cushing's disease. It affects the liver. And donkeys don't always show classical signs either. So I'm just being ultra cautious here. So we're going to take a little drop of more blood from her. Good lass. We played this game before, didn't we? And you didn't object. You're very good. Right, okay. Here we go, Mabel. That's it. Right, you were very good. I'm going to put this in this tube now. And then I'm going to have to put this blood into a chill pack because this is quite a specialised test. So it's going to have to be put in a, like a freezer pack to send it to the laboratory. Right, lovely.
And it's not just a blood sample that Peter needs today.
I'm just going to just check this poo.
Now, that's beyond a joke, lad, wearing gloves.
Well, I've delicate hands, Mrs. Green.
Oh, you've got housewife's hands, have you?
Housewife's hands, yes. Okay. Yes.
Yeah, just tough as us.
I'm just going to just break it down and have a look at it and see if there's anything obvious there to see. I know Jeannie has wormed Mabel recently, but nevertheless, I'm not going to leave any stone unturned and we're going to send this off to the lab as well. Right, I'll be in touch soon.
Fingers crossed, we're waiting for the results and see what becomes on it. Might be out in the summit. So we're just hoping and praying. Everything comes out hunky dory, Jack and Ari.
Jean and Steve Green don't have many worries.
Come on, you donkeys.
Let's have you.
But recently, their donkey Mabel's not been well, and they're waiting for Peter to bring them her latest test results.
Come on, you donkeys.
We're up at results are good, aren't we?
Yeah.
As Grandma always said, you don't know what's in the cookie jar till you get the lid off. Come in!
How are you doing?
Taking to mouth.
Good. I'm pleased to hear it. I've come to let you know what the bloods were, and I'm going to be polite and say the faeces sample. I've brought news of the faeces sample as well. Now, the bloods, I was concerned that we might have a condition called Cushing's disease, but I'm pleased to say that we haven't got Cushing's disease.
That
is good. But the faeces sample, that has shown that there's a fair amount of worms in there, despite worming her.
Don't pen it.
That wormer you used, there's possibly some resistance, but I've bought another super wormer today to hopefully sort things out.
The worms they've got, they must be a rare breed.
Well, there'll be a breed no longer by the time I've finished with them, Mrs. Green. Now, girls, are you all right?
Well, I've got door. Are you in, lad?
I mean, we've got to get the dose right. We don't want to give them too much.
And I don't want too little.
No, we've got to get it just right. Good lass. It's all right. It's all right, Mabel. There now. That's lovely. Head up. We don't want you spitting out. This is a polite house. All right, Mabel, I know you're not very happy with me, but you needed to have it. You need it to have it because you've got visitors in your tummy that we don't want. Now, Sybil, you normally get away scot-free, don't you? You normally get away scot-free. But nice. It's your turn now, isn't it? We're going to worm them both because it would be sensible, because it's highly likely that if Mabel's got some, that Sybil's got them as well. All right, Sib. Good girl.
Sammy's quiet on this.
That's it. Beautiful creatures. That'll help her. And a bit of nice Dr. Green, a bit of nice green grass. Over the next month or so, I'm hoping she picks up a bit. Right, very good. Right.
Well, thank you, Peter.
We'll see you soon. Take care.
Take care, son.
And with the help of Mr. and Mrs. Green, not to mention Dr. Green...
Don't they look grand?
I don't know.
It's not long before Mabel's on the mend.
What's the matter? Golly, no. Do you not have any finger? Oh, it's great to see her looking better. And she was, oh, brilliant. She's not thin. She looks magical.
She is.
Uncle Peter's come to rescue her again, hasn't he, Mabe? You're over at Moon now. She's a lot better than she was.
Oh, yeah, yes.
We're as happy as pigs in.